So now we go to take the topic is object oriented analysis design. First we go to see what introduction part. So what is object oriented analysis design? So object oriented analysis design is a technical approach for analyzing and designing the software applications, that one is OOAD. So this OOAD is classified into three types. The first one is OOA, object oriented analysis. The second one is OOD, object oriented design. The third one is OOP, so that one is object oriented programming. So first we go to see what is object oriented analysis. Here the object oriented analysis means it is the analysis part. Okay, so we go to do one project means that requirement is gathered from the customers. So first we go to gather the information from customers, so then we go to analysis. This analysis phase is classified into five phases. The first one is requirement phase. First one is requirements. The second one is design. The third one is implementations. The fourth one is verifications. The fifth one is maintenance. So these are the phases of object oriented analysis. The second one is object oriented design. So what is design? After analysis we go to enter into the object oriented design phase. Okay, so this phase is mainly used for the planning purpose only. You go to used here, I go to take one example for bank details. So bank details, okay, here I go to take this one is bank account. So second one is I give to, so bank account here, this one is the class name. Okay, bank account is the class name. Then I go to take the attributes. So attributes is taken from this bank account. Here I go to take the account name or account number. Okay, account number. So balance amount. So these are we go to take attributes. The third part is the methods. So method. So method means what? Here bank account means what functions we go to do. Here we go to deposit and withdraw. So these two are the methods. I give another example for OOD. Here I go to take the window. Okay, window, it is a class name. So window is the class name. Here I go to take attributes. So what are the attributes in window? So attributes window means it is shape. What is the shape or what color? So these are the attributes. We give the methods or functions, both are same, methods or functions. So here I go to take the movement of door or open or close. These are the functions of window. So move, close or open. So this one is the example for methods and functions. Okay, the third one is OOP. So this one is the object oriented programming. So already we learned in object oriented C++, we learned the features of object oriented programming. So that what? First one is class. What is class? The second one is object. Then the third one is abstractions. The fourth one is encapsulations. The fifth one is polymorphism. The last fifth one is inheritance. So these are the features of object oriented programming. Okay. So first, what is class? Okay. So class is a one type of abstract data type is called class. Okay. So here first I go to take what is the class name of particular programming. Okay. So that one is you go to find out the class name. So the second one is object. So what is object? It is a instance of class is called object. Instance of class is called object. The third one, what? Abstractions. So abstractions and encapsulations are same concept. Okay. So what is abstractions and encapsulations means? We not see visible on the internal part. Only we go to see the external part only. So that one is called abstractions and encapsulation. Here I go to take one example. You take the ATM machines. Okay. So ATM machines, we go what purpose we go to use? We go to take money. So you go to insert the card and we go to enter our details only. Okay, card number only. So then we go to get the money, but we don't know what is going on the internal part. Okay, so that concept is called abstractions and encapsulations. So the next one is polymorphism. The fifth one is polymorphism. Polymorphism is another name is it is called many forms. Okay, so many form is called polymorphism. The sixth one is inheritance. So this concept, what is inheritance means? It is having the two classes. Okay, old class and new class. Okay, so the new class is derived from the old class. Okay, so the new class is derived from the old class is called inheritance. The inheritance having so many types: single inheritance, multiple inheritance. Now we don't need deep concept. So the next one, we go to take the another topic is object oriented methodology. Object oriented methodologies. So these object oriented methodology is under this topic, it is classified into four types. Okay, the first one is object oriented analysis. It is developed by Code and Yordan. Code and Yordan. Okay, so the second one is object oriented design methodology. So this one is developed by Grady Booch. So this OOAD is otherwise called Booch methodology, object oriented methodology or Booch methodology. The third one is object oriented modeling. So that one is OOM. Okay, this one is developed by James Rombach. So that one is object oriented modeling. Okay, the fourth one is object oriented software engineering. So this one is called OOSE. Okay, so this one is developed by Jacobson. So object oriented methodology, under this one it is classified into four types. Object oriented analysis, it is developed by Code and Yordan. The second one is object oriented design. This one is Grady Booch. So this one is otherwise called Booch methodology. The third one is object oriented modeling. It is developed by James Rombach. The fourth one is object oriented software engineering. It is developed by Jacobson. So the first methodology, so we go to call Code and Yordan methodology. So here we go to see what is Code and Yordan methodology. Here first we go to identify what is the class and what is the object. Identification of classes and object. So that one is important. So first you understand what is class and what is object. Okay. So the object is created by the class. When you first you go to take the class name. For example, I take student detail. Okay. So student detail, first I go to write the class name. So class name, how do you go to write? First you write class, then class name is what? Student. Okay. So student. Then we go to create the object. So that object is created by, depend upon the that class name. Okay. So we go to create the object student. You give any name. For example, I go to create S1. So here the student is a class name. The S1 is the object. So that one is very important. What is class and what is object? Okay. The second one is identifications of structures. Identification of structures. The third one is definitions of the class, object and attributes. Okay, so this one is the object oriented analysis or code and Jordan methodology. Here first we go to identify the classes and object, then identifications of structures, then you go to define the classes, object and attribute. Okay, so we go to see the next methodology is Booch methodology. So Booch methodology. So in Booch methodology, this approaches to classify into two types. Okay, two types. Here the first one is micro improvement. Micro improvement. The second one is macro improvement. Okay, first we go to see what is micro improvement. Micro improvement means here we go to draw one diagram. So that one is the first you go to identify class. Okay, first we go to identify class. Next we go to identify the semantics of class and object. What is the meaning of semantics? It is the meaning of classes and objects. So the second step is we go to identify the semantics of object. Okay, the third one is identify the relationship of the class and object. Identify the relationship of class and object. So this one is the third one. Next, the fourth one is interface and implementations. Interface and implementations. So in micro development improvement process, we go to having the four step: identify the class, identify the semantics of the class and object, then identify the relationship of class and object. The last one is interfaces of implementations. Okay, so relationship means the classes having the one or two class name is one class is connected to the other classes. So you go to connect one relationship. Okay, so that one is the identify the relationship of objects. Okay, the second one is macro development process. Okay, the second one is macro. So in macro development process, first we go to identify the basic need of the software. Okay, what are the basic needs? Basic need of the software. Okay, so second you go to find the analysis phase. Analysis phase. The third one is we go to design that particular phase. Okay, third one is design. The fourth one is we go to develop the particular problem. Development phase. The last one is maintenance. So these are called the macro development process. Okay. So the third one is OMT. So object modeling technique. So this developed by James Roombach. Okay. So this technique consists of four phases. Okay. The first one is analysis. In OOAD, most of the part the analysis requirements, these phases are repeated. Okay, so analysis. The second one is system design. The third one is object design. The fourth one is implementations. Okay, so here what is analysis? So the customers give one problem to project team. So that project team is get the requirement from the customers. See what are the problems. Okay. Then after you get the problem, then you go to analysis. Okay. So the analysis is mostly it is a problem statement. So this one is problem statement. Okay. So the problem statement, the second one is system design. So the system design having the two part. Okay, the first one is object model. So object model. The second one is functional model. Okay, so system design contains the two part. One, the first one is the object model. The second one is functional model. So what are the methods used for particular project? Okay, the object model means what are the objects. So you go to find out first what is the classes, then you go to find out the what are the object used in. Okay, the third one is object design. Okay, so this one is the full detail of the object details. Okay, the fourth one is implementations part. Okay, so here the objects are implemented. After object design process, the objects are implemented. So these are the OMT model, object modeling technology. Okay, the fourth one is OOSC, object oriented software design. Okay, here also, so the object oriented software engineering. Okay, so this one is covers the entire life cycle of the software oriented engineering. Okay, so entire life cycle of the model. So OOSC is carry out the first three model: object oriented analysis, modeling and design. Okay, so this one is called heart of the methodology. OOSC is called heart of the methodology. Here use the use case concept. So use cases means the use cases is representing oval shape. Okay, so this one is the use case concept is otherwise called scenario. Okay, scenario means what? It is a graphical representations. That one is called the scenario. Okay, scenario for understanding the system requirements. Okay, so the OOSC also having the five models. The first model is the requirement model. The second one is analysis model. The third one is design model. The fourth one is implementation model. The fifth one is test model. Okay, it is the types of model in OOSE. So next we go to see the UML diagrams. Diagrams in the UML. Diagrams in UML. What is UML? It is the Unified Modeling Language. Unified Modeling Language. So in diagrams in UML, we having the 8 types of diagrams. Okay, the first one is class diagram. The second one is object diagram. The third one is use case diagram. The fourth one is sequence diagram. The fifth one is collaborations diagram. The sixth one is activity diagram. Seventh one is component diagram. The last one is deployment diagram. So these are the UML diagrams. We go to see one by one. Okay, the first one is what is class diagram. Class diagram. So here, what is class diagram? So the class diagram shows here set of classes. Okay, we go to take first set of classes. Okay, so then you go to find what are the relationships. Relationships. Okay, here we go to take one example for class diagram. Here I go to divided into 3 parts. So no, first one is class name. Here I go to take the class name is shape. SHAP, shapes. Okay. So next we go to write the attributes of the class name. So here I take the attribute is origin. Okay, origin. Here the third one is methods. So methods means what? Or size of, display of. So this one is the method of this shapes. Okay. So here I go to use the generalization relationship. Okay, so again we go to classify into this shape. Here I take another shape for this one. For example, that one is rectangle. So this rectangle is splitted into the shape. Okay, so another I go to take on class shape is circle. Here I go to take one. Here also I give the attributes and methods. Here also I go to take the attributes and methods. So these are the class diagram. This one is the example of class diagram. The second one is object diagram. So object diagram, it is, so it also shows the set of objects. Set of objects. So here we go to use more, two or more object means one object is connected to the other object. So here also we go to use the relationship concept. Relationship concept. Okay, here I go to splitter. I take company. Okay, for example, I take one IT organizations. Okay, take company is a class name. Here that company having the what different departments. campaigning. Okay, so this one is the object diagram, where we go to use object, you go to must, you go to underline that particular word. Okay, so now only you go to understand this one is the object. Okay, so campaigning, so here I go to split it into the company having the departments. First I go to take department name, for example department 1. Okay, so this one is the class name. Here I go to create one object for this class 1, so D1. So D1 is the object name, department 1 is a class name, so you go to underline. Here we go to use the class name and object. Okay, so the second one is department 2. Here we go to create an object, department 2 is called D2. Okay, so these are the object department. Next you go to create another department, for example department 3. Here you go to take department 3, so D3 is your object. So these D1, D2, D3 are departments, so objects. So these objects are connected to each other. Okay, so this one is the object diagram. So the third one is use case diagram. In class diagram, in object diagram, we go to draw the rectangle box. Okay, so this rectangle box is split into class name, attributes, methods or functions. In use case diagram, we use the symbol is oval shape. Okay, here we go to use the actors. So this one is users. Okay, users or customers. In particular project, you use the users or customer, means you represent this actor symbol. Customers. Okay, so use case, here it is a set of, what is use case? Okay, it is a set of use cases and actors. So the actors is the man symbol. Okay, so actors. Okay, so this is the otherwise called special kind of classes. Special kind of classes. The use cases is otherwise called special kind of classes. Okay, so the next one, we go to draw one example. For here also you take the bank details. Bank detail. Here we go to draw first. You having one account in bank means you know your bank account number, your ID. Then you go to check the balance. Okay, you go to withdraw the money. Otherwise, you go to deposit the money. So all thing you having. So first you go to take the diagram. For first one is check balance. You take any examples. Okay, so the second use case is deposit. The third one is withdraw. Withdraw cash. Okay, so the fourth one is transfer. Okay, so again you go to take two, maintenance. The last one is repair. Okay. Okay, so these are in bank details. Here we go to uses the actors. Okay, here actors means the check balance, deposit, withdraw, transfer. These are do only by the customers. So only do by the customer. So customer means here you go to represent the actor symbol. Okay, so you go to link. Okay, the customer will do the check balance, deposit, withdraw and transfer the money. Okay, here you go to draw the bank. This one is the bank. Okay, so bank also connected these process, check balance, deposit, withdraw and transfer. Okay, so here the maintenance repair, so this one is doing by the ATM technicians. Okay, ATM technician only do this, the maintenance purpose and repair. This also linked to the bank. So this one is the use case diagram. So use case diagram. Okay. So the fourth one is interactions diagram. Interactions diagram. So the interaction diagram is classified into two types. That one is the sequence diagram. The second one is collaborations diagram. So explain interaction diagram is you draw these two, sequence and collaborations. Mostly these two diagrams are used for transferring the messages to one person to other person. Okay, so that time you use this interactions diagram. Okay, so first, what is interactions diagram means? The interactions diagram shows the org. Okay, org then consisting of set of objects, and relationship is called, it is the sequence diagram. Okay. So how do you go to draw this? First one is sequence. In sequence diagram, mostly used in the online payment system. Okay, online. For example, Flipkart, Amazon. Here we go to order one thing means you get the messages. The item is shipped, packed. So we are getting the messages. That he use this sequence diagram. Okay, first you go to draw this one. This one is the shipment purpose. Then we go to get the invoice also. Part list. Okay. So particularly the sequence diagram is the ordering time. Time ordering purpose we use this sequence diagram. This one is the shipment. So this one is the invoice. So this one is the part list. So here we get the message. Okay, the receipts or goods are shipped. We get the message from particular online shopping. Okay, so here check item. Then item status. The last one is the product is delivered. So mostly this diagram is used for sending and receiving the message purpose.